What's up? This is Bam Margera. I'm here on the Howard Stern Show for the second time. Here to talk about the Viva La Bands tour and Jackass 2.5 and Missy getting her ass checked in Dubai for drugs on her honeymoon. I don't know how that happened, but it's pretty interesting. So she's
going to be joining you in there at some point, I'm sure.
Plus Howard likes her, so I'm sure he's going to call her in regardless.
All right, man. We'll see you inside, man.
All right, cool.
Cool. Thanks, man.
Of course, you know Bam from Jackass movies, all that skateboarding stuff. He's an international celebrity now. And his beautiful wife is with him, Melissa. Hey, you guys.
How you doing?
Real good. How you been?
I'm pretty good. We just got done filming Jackass 2.5, so...
Yeah, so I heard.
What's
Jackass
that?
2.5 is going to be a movie or a TV show or a DVD?
It's going to be a Christmas release DVD because, we went for it so bad on the second one, and we had, like, so much extra footage, but we didn't want to make it a three-hour movie because anything 3 hours gets boring, you know?
Right.
So we just made it a good 90 minutes and then...
Smart.
Yeah, and then we had some stuff, like I ripped out Don Vito's teeth with my Lamborghini
at
full speed. And the only reason why he did it is because I said that I'd get him brand new teeth when they got ripped out. He's like, all right, fine. If you're going to buy me new teeth, I'll do it. So,
how many teeth are you talking about? Like
two. He has two.
Two. He had two in his head.
Two really, it looks like a horse toenails. Like they're just so dirty, he doesn't even brush them.
But aren't those toenail teeth very important to him when you only have two teeth? When you think about it, like, that's your whole means of eating and everything else. So, I mean, that's
your
hardcore.
Smile.
Yeah, he couldn't eat anything. He was like eating pizza and the cheese. He was just ripping the cheese off. He couldn't eat the bread.
Oh.
And you guys love that stuff. But in a way, it's sad. I mean, the man can't eat, right? I mean, you don't see the sadness in that.
Well, when I got him new teeth, they knocked him out to install new teeth. And I got vampire teeth installed in there, and then he wakes up. He's like, "You son of a bitch! You asshole! You said you were going to get me teeth." I'm like, "Yeah, vampire teeth." So he had those in for 5 months.
Get him with them teeth.
5 months until he got real ones.
Do you now? When you do something like that, how do you pull out the teeth on video?
He said with the Lamborghini.
How do you do it? You tie a string to them?
Like fishing string to the two front teeth. Oh. And then
whack.
Tied it to the back of the Lambo and then just went full speed and just they ripped
how
right out.
How much pain was he in?
Oh, man. His whole mouth was just bloody, and he was just, like, just yelling at the top of his lungs.
And does everything come out root and everything? I mean, just like...
Yeah, it was the full tooth.
Why do you think he does it? I mean, like, I know why you do it. I mean, you get paid
good
money.
Yeah, you're driving.
I think he just likes the fact of going into Hooters, and everybody's like, oh, it's Vito, and then all these girls take photos with him and stuff. Like, that's seriously the reason.
It brings him fame.
Yeah.
Right. And if Vito said to you, look, I'll let you take my arm off, you can amputate. Would you do it? I mean, would you...
Actually,
how far does it go?
He broke his arm so bad that it got stuck, like, in a 90-degree angle, and he can't move it, so I might be able to talk him into it.
So what is it? People hang around with you, and then they all of a sudden start to want to hurt themselves and kill themselves?
I don't know.
It's almost like you guys get into...
Well, his wife hasn't done that yet, has she?
No.
No, but I gotta tell you something. I was on Bam's website, and you took beautiful naked pictures of Melissa.
Are you the photographer?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Fuck yeah. He's not going to let somebody else do that. But Melissa, you weren't uptight about that?
I was a little bit nervous, but as the day went on, I warmed up a bit.
Your legs are spread, breasts are out, panty shots.
Is he directing you? I mean, he's like, do this, do that?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, he was telling me what he wanted me to do. My girlfriend was there, too, so she was helping me.
Guys with clothes on are good at directing naked chicks. One thing I know, I've learned.
They always know what the girl should do.
Bam, why do that with your wife? Isn't that something special that you don't want to share with the world? Your wife is obviously beautiful and has a gorgeous body. I loved it.
Basically, I don't know, when Playboy approaches you and says, do you want to shoot it? It's like a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. I'm like, why not just do it? Who cares? Like,
now, I heard a terrible rumor. I was very upset. You guys are newlyweds. I heard that you guys almost broke up already. That you were...
It's bullshit.
It is bullshit.
Total.
In other words, the rumor I heard was you wanted Bam in rehab. And Bam said, no, no, no. I'm not going.
No.
It's basically half true. Like, I went on like this serious bender and completely forgot her birthday. And, you know, I even made dinner reservations at this really nice place called Dilworthtown, and I
you like
all of
blew
her
it
friends.
All off.
Yeah, I was just sipping on a beer and forgot the whole thing. Geez. And
I'm upstairs getting dressed, ready to go. I'm so happy that he made these reservations. And then I look out the window and I see that he's just getting in his brother's car. I'm like, hey, what are you doing? He's like, I'm going to the bar. I'm like, it's my birthday. What are you doing?
So the
are
next
you starting
day,
to take her for granted? I mean, she's a beautiful girl. She can get guys.
I don't know what happened. And then she was just like, you need to go to rehab. I'm like, yeah, I think I might. So my manager set up this nice place in Arizona, and I had a layover in Denver, and I was just like so hungover, all hot and cold and hot and cold. My layover in Denver, my buddy Tim Glom from Filthy Note Records is just there at the airport waiting for me. He was going to fly to Tucson, Arizona with me. Because I had to do some interviews. So I talked to Brett Michaels from Poison.
There's like, a good influence.
And he's like, because Vane's Agenda is on their tour now, which is on Filthy Note. So
I'll get to all that. I'll explain what you're talking about.
Yeah,
so the truth is, you almost did break up.
No. The truth is, he almost went to rehab.
Right.
So you never went.
I almost.
Yeah.
Well, are you
Brett
still
Michaels,
drinking?
Brett, yeah.
Oh, you are?
But Brett Michaels says, he's like, I've been there. It's not for you. You're going to be playing water volleyball and puzzles and stuff. I'm like, I don't want to do puzzles and group activities. He's like, you're better off just renting a car and driving across country and clearing your head. So I was like, you know what? So I drove from Denver to Minneapolis and
cleared your head.
Yeah, and
how
it
does
worked.
Driving across country clear your head?
Who knew that
just
that was
I didn't
the cure?
Talk to
right.
Yeah, it kind of worked though. Like,
it's a lot cheaper, isn't it?
I just wanted to do like random normal stuff, like fishing and whatever, you know.
Right. No puzzles for you.
Just because it was like filming from 9 a.m. till 9 p.m. every single day, and like after you do that for 40 days, you're just like like you just want to rush straight to the bar and have like 8 shots of whiskey.
Bam, you've got a career that no one could really define. I mean, you do the Jackass movies, you do wild stunts. Also, you're an athlete. You also get endorsement deals and things like that. And, you know, it got me thinking, you know, I've never, ever had an endorsement deal. I'm considered too wild for a company. And yet, I even see Steve-O, who has peed on red carpets and done all kinds of wild things. And he's endorsing a chewing gum, a Wrigley's chewing gum commercial.
Yeah.
How is it that I am more disgusting than you and Steve-O? I don't understand that. Do you, Robin?
Why is it okay to have Steve-O or Bam endorse a product, but if you touch it, it's the kiss of death?
I know.
I
you guys.
Understand.
You guys are way grosser than me, aren't you?
Well, I don't know. I think for me, it's because... you know, I'm a professional skateboarder, so, you know, I could have skate shoes with my name on it and, you know, an Element clothing Bam line and, you know, Bam sunglasses and...
I know, because, I mean, to kids, like Gary's kids, that age...
Right.
Mm-hmm. They don't care about Arnold Schwarzenegger. They don't care about... they care about you.
Yeah.
They care about Bam. Mm-hmm. Bam is the thing. And a lot of the old farts don't understand this.
But my point is that... You know, he's still crazy.
No, he is crazy. In fact, I got an email. Listen to this. This must be some controversy that's going on. Now, you, listen to this. Howard, please ask Bam to do all of us a favor and take the final step in selling out and moving from Westchester. You live in Westchester, I guess, right here in New York.
No, in Pennsylvania.
Oh, Westchester, Pennsylvania. Okay.
Yeah.
The guy draws unwanted attention to our town and is often seen driving through the borough, revving the engine in his electric blue Lamborghini while his wife acts like a superstar. It's ridiculous. And most people just wish he would leave. Big fan. And
they want you out of there.
That must be the township people.
Right. Yeah. Is it true that the township, because I'm stealing their thunder.
I got to tell you, I mean, I would be afraid to have you as a neighbor. I mean, you're a wild man. I mean, you're crazy, right?
Well, I bought a lot of land, like, hoping to be able to do what I want, but little did I know that the township supervisor lives directly across the street from me, and she just stalks me all day long.
How much land did you buy?
14 acres.
14? Now, you'd think on 14 acres, that's
and
a large...
And yet, she's right across the street.
Yeah, and she has nothing better to do than to spy on me all day.
So your plan was, look, I'm wild, I know that. I want to be off on my own.
I don't need neighbors.
If I want to do wild shit, I'm going to do it at my house.
Right.
And no one will see. But yet, at all this 14 acres, she sits right on top of your property.
Yeah, and all in all, she's never going to get what she wants. I mean, I built a skateboard ramp, and they want to, the township wants to tear it down. They're like, this is a dangerous structure. Yeah, it is.
Of course.
It's a skateboard ramp. Like, somebody could fall on it. I fall every time I take a skateboard run. That's the whole point of skateboarding, is to keep trying a trick until you land it.
Your point is it's only dangerous
right.
to you.
Right.
Yeah, it's not like I'm going to put my grandparents up there. Like, it's only going to be
idea.
Me and Tony
Wait
Hawk and you know.
Jackass 2.5.
Yeah.
You know, let's get the grandparents
That's
on the skateboard.
That's a good idea.
So
it's not like you're going to pull your uncle's teeth out with a car.
So you built a skateboard structure. Is that what she's really complaining? Is that the extent of the wildness? Do you drive your Lamborghini all over
she
town?
She complains about the skateboard ramp. She complains about me editing in my room because she thinks that I'm making money off it, which, I mean, in a way
oh,
that
so
I am.
So now you're running a business.
Yeah, but I don't have any employees, you know?
Right.
And then I have the Sirius radio in there, like, and you know, it gets beamed to New York, and then it goes into satellites, but technically, it's just me with a tape recorder, like, I sitting on the kitchen table with
so
a bunch of buddies.
She's getting on you about zoning and everything.
Everything.
Oh, she's trying,
everything.
She wants a letter of the law kind of stuff. In other words, don't do your radio show from there. This is a private residence. It is not a place of business.
Yeah, and then, like, I'll be see. Playing some music in the little barn or whatever. Like, it's just, I
is
seriously
it very loud?
Feel like she's Hitler across the street. No.
It's not loud music?
She's Hitler. No,
she couldn't possibly hear it.
So it's only her that's complaining? Because here's a guy named Eddie who's complaining about you. He says that you drive around with a Lamborghini and you're very loud.
It's a loud car.
Yeah. And what does he mean that Melissa is walking around like a superstar?
Well, it's because she...
Look how good
dressed,
she looks.
She's dressed nice.
Yeah, you dress... You
they don't
dress
even know who she is.
Though.
You know what I mean? They
right.
just look at her from sitting in a car and think that. But...
Yeah,
if you ever talk to her, she's like the nicest person ever.
I wish we could call this woman right now on the air and work things out for
oh,
you.
Oh, I would bust
I would
her balls
to.
So bad.
So, I mean, you're a good guy, right? I mean, you're not looking to bust anyone's balls.
Oh, no. I mean, I try to be nice to everybody, but I mean, like, sometimes when I'm skating at the skate park and you know, I can't even break a sweat because every time I try to drop in, somebody's like, hey, Bam, can you talk to my nephew and sign this and take a photo? And like,
right.
And then I drop in again and it's the same thing. I'm like, I'm just going to leave because I can't even get one trick in here.
Well,
so
maybe,
that's why you built the ramp at home.
Right.
It's
well,
a training facility.
And,
yeah.
you know, I do demos in front of like 5,000 to 10,000 kids with Tony Hawk, and he has a training facility, but just because I have one and Hitler lives across the street, I can't practice. So I need to go to these demos and suck because she doesn't want me to skate it.
Oh.
Like,
so,
it's a dangerous structure, I know. That's
are you
the whole
not,
point.
Are you not skating now at this structure at all because they've shut you down?
Well, I've been filming Jackass in L.A. for the past 2 weeks, so I haven't
I
been
see.
Able to skate it anyway.
You should tell her, either you lay off me or Steve-O is moving in.
Yeah.
Then she'd really have something to worry about.
If she didn't want me to film on my property, I would just... have all the Hessians of Westchester come in and I'd say, throw a party all day long and rage it up, have 8 kegs all day long, just don't take any pictures and don't film it. And I would do it for a year straight.
I gotta tell you, Melissa looks at you with such love when you make these statements. I don't know if she can't believe it or she just...
I'll send her to a nice
yeah,
log cabin
Yeah, he already told me
something.
If that's the case.
I'll take her to the Blue Lagoon in Iceland.
Melissa, you could have had any guy. I mean, you're a good looking girl. I mean, why Bam? I mean, this is a dangerous man. This is a man who lives on the edge. This is. Do you need that sense of excitement in your life?
To a point, but then I also see the other side of him.
You know, there are times yeah. he calms down and he's just a regular guy.
Definitely.
Right.
Okay. Right after I film Anal Bead Kite.
Oh, yeah?
That's in Jackass 2.5.
What is Anal Bead Kite?
Oh, God.
Well...
Wait, you know what? I love guessing what they do off the names. Can
right,
I guess
right.
this, Bam?
Yeah, yeah.
Mm-hmm. All right. Here's what I think Anal Bead Kite is. And I'm a fan of Jackass. I like doing this. All right. I think... You or somebody, I don't know, puts anal beads in your ass.
Okay.
Maybe like, you know, 5 anal beads and attach it to
a kite
and then let the kite go in strong wind.
Yeah.
Is that it?
Boom. You got it.
Did you do that to yourself?
I thought it was too.
I did that. And
that is brilliant. Just when you think.
What are anal beads? I've never actually seen. Are they big beads?
Well, they got bigger as the more
big?
You put in.
Oh,
really?
See, that's an aspect.
They're graduated beads.
Yeah.
I didn't figure that part of it out.
Bam, is that gay to put anal beads in one's ass?
Oh, it's probably the gayest thing I ever did. But I took the gay torch from Ryan Dunn putting the car up his ass in the first film.
There
so
was a car?
I tried to one-up myself, and my intro was, Hi, I'm Bam Margera, and I just lost a lot of fans doing this, but at least I gained 4 in Key West. And I just, like,
right.
We're on Malibu Beach. I just dropped my pants and showed.
Do you remember that, Howard, from the first Jackass when his
do.
Buddy
were
Ryan?
They toy cars?
And they go to the doctor, and he has
Matchbox
to actually.
Matchbox car.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it was great. Great
the,
stuff.
The x-ray, you can see the car.
Right. Yeah, you tell the doctor he thinks he broke his tailbone at a party. He's like, you didn't break your tailbone, bub.
Yeah, I think I broke my tailbone. Now, I heard that you said that Johnny Knoxville, the great Johnny Knoxville, is in some sort of weird thing with Luke Wilson, who is the brother of Owen Wilson, who just tried to commit suicide.
Yeah,
which
is a bummer because Luke Wilson and Knoxville were really good friends, and Knoxville, like, loved messing with him. You know, he would fly an airplane around the beach that says Luke Wilson's phone number is 310, and then
this,
give the whole thing. Then
for
he would
real,
put a,
though.
Then he would put an ad in Hollywood on a big billboard that says, like, the saddest Wilson with a picture of Luke Wilson's face. And he even had a Little League baseball team that all had a Luke Wilson shirt, a picture of his shirt, and then it said, like, the baseball team sponsor on it. Like, and, you know, making toilet paper with his face, and it was...
Why does Johnny do this to Luke Wilson? He likes him, you say.
Yeah.
He likes him, but he's fucking with him.
Yeah, he's just busting his balls. But the bummer is, you know, the Owen Wilson thing happened, and then, you know, Knoxville's like, he's like, damn, man, I'm kind of bummed that I did that. I'm like, yeah, that kind of sucks. So he wrote him, like, an apology about messing with him. He's like, but I'll probably mess with him again in about 2 weeks.
I think 2 weeks is enough time. Yeah. It's not like Owen Wilson died or anything. I mean, he's...
We're looking at his wrist. We can't even see anything.
I tell you, it would be hard to be friends with Johnny if he was busy flying my phone number around.
Right, yeah. I would be a little pissed.
Yeah. He's the kind of guy you want to, you know, avoid sometimes as a close friend. Now, what about your uncle? You mentioned Don Vito.
Yeah.
Is he doing okay? He was up on charges.
Is everything all cleared
What's
up?
What's going on now? Give us an update.
Well, the criminal charges are okay, but the idiot had 4 piss tests that were positive with some kind of, I don't know, Vicodin or whatever he's taking.
You have the greatest family.
Yeah, oh, dude, half my family's on PCP and Marcus Hook. It's insane.
But so is he back in jail now?
No. It was basically, he just... You know, in Colorado, in these little towns, like the same place where Kobe Bryant, you know, that thing happened, it's like they love seeing their name in the paper next to Kobe Bryant. It makes them feel like a big shot lawyer.
Right.
And they stretch it out for 2 years when it can end in 2 months.
Right.
That's the whole thing. And then you wind up paying like 70 grand when you could have ended it in 10 grand.
So, in other words, they caught him with some substance in his bloodstream. So, therefore, he was on probation and now he's in trouble because of that.
So, he's in trouble because of that. But, you know, basically, it was just an autograph signing, and he was drunk, and he tapped a boob or something. I don't know. I wasn't there, but...
But he's working this out somehow.
Yeah, it's worked out.
And you, too, were reportedly arrested for public drunkenness, right?
That's bullshit, too.
That is.
I was in New Hope, and I have the Lamborghini.
Yes.
And I put 2 hours in the meter. And then this lady comes out. She's writing me a ticket. I'm like, what the fuck you write me a ticket for? I'm like, I gave you two hours in the meter. And she's like... Your tire's on the white line. I'm like, look how close the other tire is to the curb. There's 1 inch to the curb. What do you want me to drive up the fucking thing? I'm like, you're probably giving me a ticket for that too. It's a wide car. It's a Lamborghini. So she gives me a ticket anyway. And then she goes, you can't cuss in this town. I'm like, I can't cuss in New Hope, PA. And then I say, bitch, slut, whore, dyke. And then she wrote on the paper that I called her a fucking cunt. And I was sipping on an iced tea that day. And, you know, the police come. They're like, how much you had to drink, sir? I'm like, nothing. I had iced tea. You know, and they're like, well, witnesses say. I'm like, witnesses say you have one witness, and it's her, that fat bitch meter maid. I'm like, I have the whole bar right here that saw what happened.
So they arrested you?
No.
They gave me a $300.
Yeah, in
$300.
The mail.
I see. So do you think it's because you're famous and you have a Lamborghini? Do you think there was jealousy involved, perhaps?
I think she's just a miserable lady who hates her life and just likes to give people tickets. And, you know, I just thought it was bullshit because I just pumped 8 quarters in the meter and then I look over and I'm getting a ticket. And who cares about the $20 tickets? Just the principle of it.
Can you believe all of this fame, Bam? Because, I mean, I read that that a woman paid for her grandson $6,800 on eBay to hang out with you for a day.
Yeah.
Is that true?
Yeah.
Yeah. Now, does that make you feel good? I mean, the fact that somebody paid $6,800 just to hang out with you?
Well, that was to charity, wasn't it?
Yeah, all went to a charity. Landry.
And what do you have to do with these kids? I mean,
they just hang out with me for the day. Like, you know, they'll be chilling with me when I'm filming.
Is that a pain or is that okay?
It kind of all depends on what kind of kid it is. You know, it's kind of hard to hang out with a shy kid who has nothing to say. You know, like, I'd rather have somebody who's like, hell yeah, man, I'm hanging out with Bam.
You that kid went really well, though.
Yeah.
Can you hook these kids up to an anal bead kite? Can you pull their teeth out?
What can we do with them?
Yeah, what can you do with these kids?
They usually just watch me film, and then we move to another location, I'll have them get in a Lamborghini, and I'll drive them around, and they, you know, they have a good time.
I take them out to lunch or something.
Oh, I believe you.
Then
I'll
skate
I pay $6,800 to go to lunch with you.
There you go.
I'm all
that's
about
the
that.
Auction you want to be
I don't know if it's worth the money, but we try.
I remember the last time you guys were here, you described your sex life. It sounded fantastic. You were driving around in the Lamborghini, and you guys had sex in the car, right?
In the Hummer.
In the Hummer, it was.
Because it's bigger.
Yeah.
Yes. Everything went down in that Hummer, right?
Oh, big time. Blow pretty job, much in everything. Every car, but...
Melissa, you're very sexual, I take it. You'd have to be with this guy, right? I mean, you got to be very adventurous.
We're happy.
Does he do anything crazy in bed that you like? Is there something you can share with us that he
Lately
does?
I have been because we've been hanging out with the porn star Gina Lynn and Travis. They live in Reading, PA because she's in my new movie called Ming Hags, and she plays my girlfriend and half-sister. So
Gina Lynn. Now, yeah. I've had she's up for any party.
Oh, yeah.
Do you two girls ever get naked in front of each other?
No. We're just friends.
Now, she never tries to come on to you, maybe go down on you, do something wild?
No.
She would.
She would.
I'm not...
You're not up for that. You're not interested in another woman. And Bam, you've never gotten it on with her? You never did a swap thing or anything like that?
Well, I kissed her in the movie and stuff, but that was just for the movie.
So what kind of wild stuff are you getting into as a result of knowing Gina? What are you trying out on Melissa?
Well, she gave me like a stack of like 30 porn, so I've been watching them, and I just see how much they like, they just talk and just like... You know, before I was just kind of shy, but now I don't care. I'll talk all kinds of shit.
Yeah. Oh, so you got into the dirty talk, huh?
We talk to each other a lot.
What kind of dirty stuff do you and Bam say to each other, Melissa? I mean, in bed. I mean,
don't ask me that. You answer.
Put it in me. Give it to me. Come on. You know you want to. That kind of stuff?
Basically nonsense.
Well, I tell you, that's amazing. Now, I heard a terrible incident about the two of you. You were in Dubai. I think it was your honeymoon.
Perhaps. Yeah.
And you, now, this is very erotic in some weird way. Melissa was strip searched and searched anally by a man?
No.
It was by a woman.
It was a woman.
And a woman.
Even better.
With no gloves on.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Okay, now wait a second.
Yeah.
Where is this Dubai? I don't even know.
It's right next to Saudi Arabia. It's in the Persian Gulf.
That sounds bad already.
It's like the richest city ever. But and you know, we were going there for our honeymoon, and PerezHilton.com made a joke. It says, Bam and Missy are going to Dubai for their honeymoon. And it's like, don't bring any drugs into the country, ha ha ha, because the music producer, I forget his name, but he got busted with coke there, and he's in like real big trouble.
Sure.
So when we flew in, I guess they saw that or something, or maybe they thought we were somebody else, but they busted our balls so bad. They were like taking out her cigarettes and tapping out each and every one of the cigarettes to see if there was any weed in it.
Right.
They stripped me naked, and I don't care.
Who strips you naked?
A guy.
A guy stripped you naked?
Yeah, and he's like...
They take you in a private room?
Yeah, they separated us.
And that's
us.
Scary. You get separated.
Yeah.
They from Bam's end, he goes into a room with a man. Mm-hmm. One man or multiple men?
One man.
One man. And he says, okay, son, take off your clothes.
Take off everything?
Yeah.
And you don't care because you do anal bead kites.
Yeah, right.
And you take off all your clothes, and what does he do an anal search on you?
And he...
Everyone's involved with your asshole.
Yeah, and then he was like lifting my dick up to see if I have weed taped to it and stuff. Geez. I'm like, I don't even like weed, you know?
Right.
And then she has a prescription to Xanax, and I have a prescription to Adderall, and they're looking at it with a microscope, and they're like, trying to see if it's ecstasy or something, like, and we're in there for literally 2.5 to 3 hours of just getting our balls busted.
Now, Melissa, your story is even more exciting to my audience because you're a very attractive young girl, and you are brought into a separate room, and now you're scared.
Yes.
I would imagine this is something you're not used to. All you wanted to do was go on your honeymoon.
Exactly.
She informs you that you have to be completely nude for your search?
Yes.
All right. So now where do you undress? Do you undress in front of her or they give
in
you
in front of her. No, she took me into a room. There was like a box drawn on the floor with like yellow tape that I had to stand in the box.
What does she look like, the woman?
All I could see was her eyes. She had like full Arabic
garb. She had the whole
garb.
That's even more creepy.
Yeah. Arabic garb.
She took my passport
from me.
She put it in like a pouch in her uniform. She has
all the lights are on?
All the lights are on, yeah. There's no windows. There's no
candles,
one else in there. It's
nothing.
Private.
Okay, go ahead.
No candles.
All right.
There's just a table.
I'd have candles. I'd put on music and candles. So now you're probably shaking. I mean, you're probably like, this is weird.
Very upset.
This is a stranger,
yeah.
Right? Yeah.
I took my clothes off. I still had my bra.
When you say you took your clothes off, what were you wearing that you needed to take off?
Just like jeans and probably a sweater and boots.
All right. And you know you're very voluptuous, and you know people can get turned on. So they said probably this was everything about you is sexual. Isn't that true? So you begin to undress, you go into the box and you begin to undress in front of a woman in a full outfit, Arabic outfit.
Yeah.
And what comes off first, the pants or the top?
I think my shoes, then my pants, then my top. And I thought I was done at that point and she would...
You're in bra and panties at this point?
Yeah.
What do you wear, a thong?
I think I had like boy shorts on because I was traveling and they're more comfortable than a thong.
This must have been quite a sight.
Yeah, little boy shorts and a bra and...
Right.
And then she says...
Those two, something along the lines.
She says, that's true. Don't think you're going to get off easy.
Look, Missy.
So I took off my panties. I took off my bra. All my clothes were on a table sitting next to me.
Now, do they go through your clothes?
Yeah.
So you stand there naked while she goes through your clothes.
She's shaking all my clothes out. And as I'm standing there... completely nude, she starts to ask me questions about my family. She starts to ask me about my mother, my father, who has been dead for 6 years, my brother. I don't even have a brother.
How big are your tits?
You can see them. Like,
right.
You know?
Yeah.
So she's just questioning me. And
why do you think she asked you all that?
I have no idea.
A little conversation?
I don't have to do with
this.
All right. And you're standing there completely nude.
Yeah.
And are you completely shaven? I remember in the Playboy shoot you were, I believe.
No, not completely.
Not completely. You're not completely shaven.
No, I'm well groomed, but not completely.
Was she staring at your body in a lesbian kind of way?
No.
Right.
But you're still standing in the box.
I'm still standing there cold and naked.
Oh, that's awesome. Yeah. I mean, that's horrible.
The worst part was she told me to turn around. And, like, all I could think about is every movie that I've ever seen where they, like, put the person up against the wall and, like, you know, check them. She put one hand on either of my butt cheeks
How close to your actual ass, though?
Like
an inch away?
In my butt.
All right, let me ask you a question. Let's back up a second.
Go ahead.
Because even Bam isn't clear on this. See, you'd have to tell me this every night before I if you were my wife. But all right. Now she says she's going to, you know, she tells you to turn around.
Yeah.
You put your hands up on a wall? Is this box near a wall?
I didn't have to put my hands on a wall. I just had to spin around.
And she says what, bend over?
No, I didn't even bend over. She just
got on her knees?
She just went like this. To my butt, grabbed it, and just spread my butt open without even saying, like, okay, we're going to do an anal. She didn't even warn me what was coming.
She spread your cheeks wide open, and as Bam asked,
spread and looked
into your asshole.
Mm.
Wow.
Wow.
Yeah.
Tell me again about your father.
Hello.
What about your vagina now? Is it?
No, she didn't touch my vagina. She, like, looked to see if there was anything in my panties.
Right.
But she didn't touch my vagina.
Did you get wet at all, if I may ask?
No.
You did not.
You were not really aroused. Upset. Mm-mm.
Upset, but somehow strangely turned on.
I can see why you would think that, but no.
It wasn't anything like that.
Mm-mm.
Did she have nice eyes at least? That's all you could say?
She had beautiful eyes.
At any time was her finger inserted into your ass?
She poked at it.
She poked at the actual brown eye.
She gave it a little tap.
And nothing on, no gloves.
No
gloves.
That's so creepy.
All right, I am going to reenact this with Fred now. Fred, you're going to be Melissa, and I'm going to be a woman in a burqa. All right? And you're going to bend over, and I'm going to, well, no bending over. Over, actually.
The burka's key.
Wow. Good
what if she moved the burka back and it was Ashton Kutcher and he went, you're punk!
I almost expected that.
In a way, the creepy thing is she's looking like Cousin It. She's covered and draped in a thing and, you know.
Right,
it's,
you don't know what's going on.
It's a little bizarre.
I was totally freaked out. So I was ready to go home.
After she spreads your cheeks and violates you that way, does she allow you to put your clothing back on?
Yes.
And even getting dressed is grotesque because you've got to get dressed.
Does she leave the room or is she still standing there?
She didn't leave me unattended for 1 second.
You have a beautiful body.
Dress slowly.
Oh, Lord.
Anybody beating off to this?
I mean, she was sexually violated.
Yeah,
I mean, to think about it.
And it's her honeymoon.
Yeah. That
it's
makes
like
it
a
even
nightmare,
way
really.
Worse. She's like, let's just get back on a plane and go home. Like, let's just power it out and get to the resort. And then, you know, and once we got there, it was fine. But what a bad first impression on Dubai, man.
Do you think the woman understood that you were Jewish as well? Because
I think that's what it was, honestly. Because my name was still Rothstein at that point because we were only married a few days.
Yes.
So she probably, they probably saw that I was Jewish. And then Bam usually wears like a rosary just as like a decorative
necklace. Oh, they were
necklace.
Pissed about that, it seemed like.
Oh, so absolutely. They're probably like a Jew, a Christian, they're married, they don't have the same last name. These, their assholes are up to something.
She's got nice titties, the whole thing. I get angry about that. Dubai is known to be unfriendly to Jews, isn't it? Pretty
yeah.
much, yes.
I think if your passport is stamped that you've been in Israel and over in a certain amount of time, like they won't even admit you to the country.
What country isn't known to being...
All right, let's pick a country that's friendly to Jews.
Jewish land?
Right. So this was very upsetting to you.
Terrible.
And then you get to the resort. When you make love that night, on your honeymoon night, does Bam say, tell me again...
No.
When you were strip searched.
But I obsessed over it for about 2 days trying to find out, like, trying to figure out why they did that.
Here's
to
the
us.
Best. We have the very top of the hotel.
Oh,
we're out on the balcony where there is no roof because we're on the roof. And she's laying in the, she's laying outside on the bed, like, you know, just sunbathing or whatever,
lounge
naked.
Chair.
I just come out and start eating her out. And then after 5 minutes. I see these five dudes up at the construction site, and they're just like, yeah, woo! And I'm just like,
too.
But they were like 60 feet above us. They're building these skyscrapers.
Guys can find anybody eating anyone out anytime.
They looked like an ant. They were so far away,
wow.
But like they just happened to notice that.
Wow.
Like,
you two are really, really on fire with your life and all of that. Now, Bam, you're here promoting something that I want to understand. You now have a record company.
Yeah.
I hope it's a video of you eating out your wife.
No, it isn't.
When are we going to see that?
You're not.
Now, first of all, I mean, you know, look, Bam is promoting all kinds of things. He's got all kinds of business. Viva La Bands is the new record album.
Yeah.
CD, I should say. Volume 2 compilation, CD, DVDs, and stores now. Now, you happen to believe that the Swedish rock scene is the next big thing, right?
Yeah.
So does our... You know Scott Greenstein thinks this as well?
Yeah, he does. He's talk to him about it all the time.
Is that right? Well, can we hear some of this? I want to know what's the next big thing.
Well, like, for example, on the record is the Bloodhound Gang. But,
okay.
You know.
Yeah.
Scott Greenstein, let me check his ass.
Bam, it's great seeing you.
Yeah, you too.
Melissa, you too. You look
too.
Better than ever.
Thank you.
You really do, and I appreciate...
Marriage agrees with you.
Marriage agrees with the two of you. Especially you, Melissa. And we're going to take a break. Don't forget to get Viva La Bands Volume 2 Compilation CD DVD is in stores now. It rocks. And listen, this is the music Bam believes in, and he seems to know what he's talking about.
He's behind it.
By the way, their next trip for their next little honeymoon is Syria, where they will be anally raped by the guards.
Right, they're going to Turkey.
Yeah, oh, Turkey.
He wants to go there.
You really want to go to Turkey?
Sure.
Yeah, why not? Yeah, you know, there they just put you right in prison and rape you. It's going to be great. You're a lucky woman.
Bam, Missy, that's a pretty ridiculous start to your honeymoon.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But all in all, it was fun. We were there for about a week to 10 days, so once we got out of the airport, then it was fine.
Got past all of, like, that horrible dramatic stuff.
And yeah, it's just such a bad first impression of Dubai.
Somehow Howard turned that whole story into like a sexy tale of almost like lesbian
I
love.
I thought that was gonna happen.
You had a feeling?
Yeah, I had an inkling.
You guys are no strangers to this show at this point, so did that help suppress some of the trauma from the experience, turning it into a sex tale?
Yeah, it made it a little easier to talk about.
Ben, you've been like under a lot of you know, media attention and stuff like that over the last 10 years, but now you've become sort of friends with Howard and friend of the show. Where does that rank, you know, with all the success from Jackass and CKYTK and all that stuff? Like, where does this rank being up here?
I mean, I'm stoked at where I'm at. You know, I just can't do any more CKY videos because, you know, you can't just show up at a supermarket and start wrecking shopping carts when you know, it's an easy lawsuit and they know that I have money now, so. It'll just become 10 lawsuits, so I can't do any more CKY videos. So
you like your app, but you can't do all like the grassroots stuff. Anymore.
Right, right. So I'm moving along to, you know, movies and other stuff and just make sure everything's legal.
All right, guys. Well, thanks for stopping by.
Yeah.